Grace, mercy, and peace to you all. We are in Mark chapter 6 through 8. The times of ignorance, ignorance of the power and majesty of the Lord, the matrix, subjective truth, Gnosticism, faith systems of men, the strong delusion, 2 Thessalonians 2 in verse 11. These times of ignorance, the Lord overlooked so that he could bring back his one faith system to a world populated with billions. So we overlooked ignorance, but now he commands all men everywhere to repent. Acts 17, verse 30. Mark chapter 6. And he went out from there, and he came into his own country, and his disciples followed him. And when Saturday was come, he began to teach in the synagogues. Again, a place of ignorance. And many hearing him were astonished, saying, whence has this man these things? And what is the wisdom that is given unto this man? And what do such mighty works wrought by his hands mean? Is not this the carpenter, the son of Mary, the brother of James and Joseph and Judas and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us? And they were offended by him. So even though they had ears to hear, he was offering them this great truth to set them free. They refused to hear, so that they could stay in the matrix. And Jesus said unto them, a prophet is not dishonored except in his own country and among his own kin and in his own house. And he could there do no mighty work, save that he laid his hands upon a few sick people and healed them. And he marveled because of their unbelief that they would not accept truth, that they chose to continue to be in the matrix. And he went around the villages teaching. And he called unto him the 12 and began to send them forth by two and two. He gave them authority over the unclean spirits, and he charged them that they should take nothing for their journey save a staff only, no bread, no wallet, no money in their purse, but to go shod with sandals and put not on two coats. And he said unto them, wherever you enter into a house, there abide till you depart thence. And whatever place shall not receive you, and they hear you not, as you go forth thence, shake off the dust that is under your feet for a testimony unto them. Don't force people to hear your teaching about the glory and majesty of God. And so for modern man, we are to do little more than asking men if they want to know about the Lord, the power and majesty, the second age of the kingdom of heaven. If they do, then point them to therodofiron.org, the Bible online, or give them a copy of it. Now note at this point, they only had in truth, just as we only had in truth. In other words, we're just starting the restoration project. 1 Corinthians 13:9-12. But we will finish as we enter into the second age of the kingdom of heaven in about 40 years. And they went out and taught that men should repent. Okay, stop being ignorant of the glory and majesty of the Lord. And they cast out many demons and anointed with oil many that were sick and healed them. Now, of course, we don't have the ability to cast out demons because they can't fight in this last spiritual warfare. And King Herod heard thereof, for his name had become known. And he said, John, the one who immersed, is risen from the dead. And therefore do these powers work in him. But others said it is Elijah, and others said it is a prophet, even as one of the prophets. But Herod, when he heard, said, John, whom I beheaded, he is risen. For Herod himself had sent forth and laid hold upon John and bound him in prison for the sake of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife, for he had married her. For John, this will be the Holy Spirit speaking through John, said unto Herod, it is not lawful for you to have your brother's wife. And Herodias set herself against him and desired to kill him. And she could not, for Herod feared John, knowing that he was a righteous and holy man, and kept him safe. And when he heard him, he was much perplexed, and he heard him gladly. And when a convenient day was come, that Herod on his birthday made a supper to his lords and the high captains and the chief men of Galilee. And when the daughters of Herodias herself came in and danced, she pleased Herod and them that sat at meat with him. And the king said unto the damsel, ask of me whatever you will, and I will give it to you. And he swore unto her, whatever you shall ask of me, I will give it you unto the half of my kingdom. And she went out and said unto her mother, what will I ask? And she said, the head of John the Immerser. And she came in straightway with haste unto the king and asked, saying, I will that you forthwith give me on a platter the head of John the Immerser. And the king was exceeding sorry, but for the sake of his oaths and of them that sat at meat, he would not reject her. And straightway the king sent forth a soldier of his guard and commanded to bring his head. And he went and beheaded him in the prison and brought his head on a platter and gave it to the damsel. And the damsel gave it to her mother. And when the disciples heard, they came and took up his corpse and laid it in a tomb. And the apostles gathered themselves together unto Jesus, and they told him all things, whatever they had done, and whatever they had taught. And he said unto them, come you yourselves apart into a desert place and rest a while. For there were many that were coming and going, and they had no leisure so much as to eat. And they went away in the boat to a desert place apart. And the people saw them going, and many knew them, and they ran together there on foot from all the cities, and outwent them. And he came forth and saw a great multitude, and he had compassion on them, because they were a sheep not having a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. See, this was opposite of those in his own country. And when the day was now far spent, his disciples came unto him and said, the place is desert, and the day is now far spent. Send them away that they may go into the country and villages round about, and buy themselves somewhat to eat. But he answered and said unto them, give you them to eat. And they say unto him, shall we go and buy 200 shillings worth of bread and give them to eat? And he said unto them, how many loaves do you have? Go and see. And when they knew, they say, 5 and 2 fishes. And he commanded them that all should sit down by companies upon the green grass. And they sat down in ranks by hundreds and by fifties. And he took the 5 loaves and the 2 fishes, and looking up to heaven, he blessed. He gave thanks for the provided food. He blessed and brake the loaves, and he gave to the disciples to set before them. And the 2 fishes divided he among them all, and they all ate and were filled. And they took up broken pieces, 12 basketfuls, and also of the fishes. And they that ate the loaves were 5,000 men. And straightway he constrained his disciples to enter into the boat and to go before him to the other side, to Bethsaida, while he himself sent the multitude away. And after he had taken leave of them, he departed into the mountain to pray. And when evening was come, the boat was in the midst of the sea, and he alone on the land. And seeing them distressed in rowing, for the wind was contrary unto them, about the 4th watch of the night he came unto them, walking on the sea. And he would have passed by them, but they, when they saw him walking on the sea, supposed that it was a spirit, and cried out, for they all saw him and were troubled. But he straightway spoke with him and said unto them, be of good cheer, it's I, be not afraid. And he went up unto them into the boat, and the wind ceased. And they were sore amazed in themselves, for they understood not concerning the loaves, but their heart was hardened. And when they had crossed over, they came to the land of Gennesaret and moored to the shore. And when they were come out of the boat, straightway the people knew him, and ran round about that whole region, and began to carry about on their beds those that were sick, where they heard he was. And wherever he entered, into villages, or into cities, or into the country, they laid the sick in the marketplaces, and besought him that they might touch, if it were but the border of his garment. And as many as touched him were made whole. Mark chapter 7. And there gathered together unto him the Pharisees and certain of the scribes who had come from Jerusalem, and had seen that some of his disciples ate the bread with defiled, that is, unwashed hands. For the Pharisees and all the Jews, except they wash their hands diligently, don't eat, holding the tradition of subjective truth of the elders. And when they came from the marketplace, except they bathe themselves, they don't eat. And many other things there are, which they have received to hold, washing of cups and pots and brass vessels. And the Pharisees and the scribes ask him, why walk not your disciples according to the traditions of the elders, the subjective truths of men, but eat their bread with defiled hands? And he said unto them, well did Isaiah prophesy of you hypocrites, as it is written, this people honors me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. But in vain do they worship me, teaching as their doctrines the precepts of men. you leave the commandment of God and hold fast the traditions of men. And he said unto them, full well do you reject the commandment of God, that you may keep your tradition. For Moses said, honor your father and your mother, and he that speaks evil of father or mother, let him die the death. But you say, if a man shall say to his father or his mother, that wherewith you might have been profited by me is Corban, that is to say, given to God, you no longer suffer him to do aught for his father or his mother, making void the word of God by your tradition, which you have delivered. And many such things you do. Of course, we've done the same thing as well. We had no choice. We were in Gnosticism. We were in the matrix. And he called to him the multitude again and said unto them, hear me, all of you, and understand. There is nothing from without the man that going into him can defile, but the things which proceed out of the man. The doctrine of men is what causes human suffering and destroys man. Remember Eve when she ate of the tree of the knowledge? In other words, she obeyed her own subjective truth. It looked good to eat. And then God cast men out of the Garden of Eden. And for 6,000 years, men have been under subjective truth of men. The things which proceed out of the man are those that defile the man. And when he was entered into the house from the multitude, his disciples asked of him the parable. And he said unto them, are you so without understanding also? Perceive you not that whatever from without goes into the man, it cannot defile him? Because it goes not into his heart, but into his belly, and it goes out into the draught. This he said, making all meats clean. And he said, that which proceeds out of the man, that defiles the man. For from within, out of the heart of men, evil thoughts proceed. Fornications, thefts, murders, adulteries, covetings, wickedness, deceit, lasciviousness, an evil eye, railing, pride, foolishness. Remember, all Gnostic doctrine of men is blasphemy against the Holy Spirit, now that we have the rod of iron. All these evil things proceed from within and defile the man. And from thence he arose and went away into the borders of Tyre and Sidon. And he entered into a house and would have no man know it. And he could not be hid. But straightway a woman whose little daughter had an unclean spirit, having heard of him, came and fell down at his feet. Now the woman was a Greek, a Syrophoenician by race. And she besought him that he would cast forth the demon out of her daughter. And he said unto her, let the children first be filled. For it is not meet to take the children's bread and to cast it to the dogs. But she answered and said unto him, yea, Lord, even the dogs under the table eat of the children's crumbs. And he said unto her, for this saying, go your way. The demon is gone out of your daughter. And she went away into her house and found the child laid upon the bed and the demon gone out. And again, he went out from the borders of Tyre and came through Sidon unto the Sea of Galilee, through the midst of the borders of Decapolis. And they bring into him one that was deaf and had an impediment in his speech. And they beseech him to lay his hands upon him. And he took him aside from the multitude privately and put his fingers into his ears and spat and touched his tongue. And looking up to heaven, he sighed and said unto him, Ephphatha, that is, be opened. And his ears were opened, and the bond of his tongue was loosed. And he spoke plain. And he charged them that they should tell no man, but the more he charged them, so much more a great deal they published it. And they were beyond measure astonished, saying, he has done all things well. He even made the deaf to hear and the dumb to speak. Mark chapter 8. In those days, when there was again a great multitude, they had nothing to eat. He called upon him his disciples and said unto them, I have compassion on the multitude, because they continue with me now 3 days and have nothing to eat. And if I send them away fasting to their home, they will faint on the way, and some of them are come from far. And his disciples answered him, whence shall one be able to fill these men with bread here in a desert place? And he asked them, how many loaves have you? And they said, seven. And he commanded the multitude to sit down on the ground. And he took the seven loaves, and having given thanks, he brake and gave to his disciples and set before them. And they set them before the multitude. And they had a few small fishes, and having blessed them, he commanded to set them also before them. And they ate and were filled. And they took up of broken pieces that remained over 7 baskets. And they were about 4,000. And he sent them away. And straightway he entered into the boat with his disciples and came into the parts of Dalmanutha. And the Pharisees came forth and began to question with him, seeking of him a sign from heaven, trying him. And he sighed deeply in his spirit and said, why does this generation seek a sign? Verily, I say unto you, there shall no sign be given unto this generation. And he left them and again entered into the boat, departed to the other side. And they forgot to take bread. And they had not in the boat with them more than 1 loaf. And he charged them, saying, take heed, beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and the leaven of Herod. And they reasoned one with another, saying, we have no bread. And Jesus, perceiving it, said unto them, why reason you because you have no bread? Do you not yet perceive, neither understand? Have you your heart hardened? Having eyes, see you not? And having ears, hear you not? And do you not remember? When I break the 5 loaves among the 5,000, how many baskets full of broken pieces took you up? They say unto him, 12. And when the 7 among the 4,000, how many baskets full of broken pieces took you up? And they said unto him, 7. And he said to them, do you not yet understand? 7 is the number for God. And they come unto Bethsaida, and they bring to him a blind man, and beseech him to touch him. And he took hold of the blind man by the hand, and brought him out of the village. And when he had spat on his eyes, and laid his hands upon him, he asked him, do you see anything? And he looked up and said, I see men, for I behold them as trees walking. Now this would represent us when we were in the matrix. Then again, he laid his hands upon his eyes, and he looked steadfastly and was fully restored. And he saw all things clearly. And he sent him away to his home, saying, do not even enter into the village. And Jesus went forth and his disciples into the villages of Caesarea Philippi. And on the way, he asked his disciples, saying to them, who do men say that I am? And they told him, saying, John the Immerser, and others Elijah, but others one of the prophets. And he asked them, but who say you that I am? Peter answered and said unto him, you are the Christ. And he charged them that they should tell no man of him. And he began to teach them that the Son of Man must suffer many things and be rejected by the elders and the chief priests and the scribes and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. And he spoke the saying openly. And Peter took him and began to rebuke him. But he, turning about and seeing his disciples, rebuked Peter and said, get you behind me, adversary. Now the Greek word is Satan, which means adversary. For you do not mind the things of God, but the things of men. And he called unto him the multitude with his disciples and said unto them, if any man would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever would save his life will lose it. And whoever will lose his life for my sake and the gospel's will save it. The gospel of the kingdom. For what does it profit a man to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? For what should a man give in exchange for his life? For whoever will be ashamed of me and my words, objective truth from God, his curriculum from the rod of iron. Whoever will be ashamed of me and my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, the Son of Man also will be ashamed of him when he comes in the glory of his Father with the holy messengers, that is the Father and the Holy Spirit.